activitatem Iacob.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Dicitur Dominus, ego cogito.
Yeah.
Spiritu Tuo.
This week, the second collection today will be taken up for the building fund. The second collection for next week will be taken up for the foreign missions collection. So this collection will be taken up for all of the missionary work that is done by the Society of St. Pius X in Asia, Eastern Europe, and Africa. So please be generous with those donations for the next week's second collection. Also, for the Feast of the Immaculate Conception on December 8th, there will be only one Mass celebrated in this area, and that's in Davie. It's in Davie at Our Lady of Victory Chapel. So On that occasion, on the feast of Immaculate Conception, Father Jacobs and myself will be making our professional engagements into the Society of St. Pius X in the morning in Sanford, and then driving to the missions in the afternoon. So, unfortunately, there won't be able to be Mass here on that day, but there will be an element of engagement in Our Lady of Victory Chapel at 6 p.m. The epistle this week is taken from St. Paul's letter to the Colossians. Brethren, we cease not to pray for you, and to the end that you may be filled with the knowledge and the will of God in all wisdom and spiritual understanding, that you may walk worthy of God in all things pleasing, being fruitful in every good work and increasing in the knowledge of God, strengthened with all might according to the power of His glory, in all patience and long suffering with joy. Giving thanks to God the Father, who hath made us so worthy as to be partakers of the lot of the saints in light, who hath delivered us from the power of darkness, and hath translated us into the kingdom of the Son of His love, in whom we have redemption through His blood and the remission of sins. Please stand for the Holy Gospel and take it from the mouth of St. Matthew. At that time, Jesus said to His disciples, "When you shall see the abomination of desolation, which was spoken of by Daniel the prophet, standing in the holy place, let he that readeth, let him understand. Then they that are in Judea, let them flee unto the mountains, and he that is on the housetop, let him come not down to take anything out of his house. And he that is in the field, let him not go back to take his coat. And woe to them that are with child and that are stuck in those days. But pray that your flight be not in winter or on the Sabbath, for there shall be even a great tribulation, such as hath not been found from the beginning of the world until now, neither shall be. And unless those days be shortened, no flesh should be saved, but for the sake of the elect, those days shall be shortened. Then if any man shall say to you, Lo, here is Christ, or there, do not believe him. For there shall arise false Christs and false prophets, and shall show great signs and wonders, and wonders so much as to deceive, if possible, even the elect. Behold, I have told this to you beforehand. If therefore they shall say to you, Behold, he is in the desert, go ye not out. Behold, he is in the closets, believe it not. For as lightning cometh out of the east and appeareth even unto the west, so also will the coming of the Son of Man be. Wheresoever a new body shall be, wheresoever the body shall be, there shall the eagles also be gathered together. And immediately after the tribulation of those days, the sun shall be darkened, and the moon shall not give the light, and the stars shall fall from the heaven, and the powers of heaven shall be moved. And then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven. And then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn. And they shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven with much power and majesty. And he shall send his angels out with a trumpet and a loud voice. And they shall gather together his elect from the four winds, from the farthest parts of the heavens to the utmost bounds of them. And from the fig tree I learn a parable. When the branch thereof is now tender, and the leaves come forth, you know that summer is nigh. So you also, when you shall see all these things, know ye that it is nigh even at the doors. Amen, I say to you, that this generation shall not pass till all these things be done. Heaven and earth shall pass away, but my words shall not pass away. Blessed are the words of Jesus, Holy God. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. As many as received Him, He gave the power to be the sons of God. In the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. In the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Thank you.
liberanos a malos.
Miserere nobis.
Mate
Thank you.